This morning, our very special guest is Anne Beiler, Auntie Anne Beiler. Good morning to you, Anne.
Good morning, Fred.
So great to have you here. We were thinking about when we saw each other last. You were here for a Live from the Junction Center with Brandon Heath.
That's correct. A number of years ago.
Yeah. And your granddaughter was with you, I remember.
That's right. Trinity. Yes, yeah, she was.
That was wonderful. So it's great to have you back. Welcome. We're going to talk about your books, but we were just chatting about how some people are surprised that Auntie Anne Beiler is a real person, that the Auntie Anne's pretzel person is real, and that's you.
I know people are surprised, but you know what I'm happy about is I'm glad that everyone knows about Auntie Anne's pretzels.
Yeah.
That's most important.
Did you ever think when you were starting all those years ago back at a market that they were going to be in every airport, every mall in America, pretty much everywhere you go?
No, we had no clue. We did one store in Downingtown, Pennsylvania was our first farmer's market. And I'll never forget the day, Fred. It was like I was standing there wondering, why am I doing this? Mm. And we had no idea that God had a great big plan for us. And it began to unfold with two stores the very first year, 1988. And then the next year, 12 more. And we continued to grow and have gone around the world. But I had no clue that first day.
Pretty exciting. You told me earlier that you could write a book about all the Auntie Anne's you go through in the airport and the experiences you've had.
Yeah, it's interesting because, as you said, most people don't know that I exist. And it's funny to me because I'm very much alive and I'm very well.
Yes, you are. Yeah. And very down to earth, which I love. So speaking of writing books, you have written a brand new book that is a cookbook. It's a recipe book.
That's correct.
It's called Come to the Table. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, the cookbook was inspired, I guess, many years ago when I did a lot of baking and I cooked as I was the baker in our family of eight kids, and I was the only one in the family that had allergies, and so I was inside with mom, and I learned how to bake and cook. And a few years, maybe 2 years ago, when my manager Gentry Lesby just said, you know, I think you need to do a cookbook, and you know, we had written a few books, and I said, well, okay, let's give it a shot. And I have to tell you, it was one of the hardest books I've ever written.
Interesting. So you've written five books.
True. Yes.
Yeah. That are available anywhere. So what made a cookbook so hard for you to write?
Well, growing up on a little Amish-Mennonite farm, you just kind of throw stuff together, you know? Mm. And mom had this little cookbook. She had little index cards and Mennonite cookbook and some of those things. But for the most part, you know, she would just ask me to make dinner and I'd throw stuff together. And baking became a little more, really became what I really enjoyed doing. And that was a little more difficult because I did have to follow a recipe, you know,
right,
for the cookies and the pies and the cakes. And so at the age of 11 and 12, I made 50 to 70 pies and cakes on a Thursday night when mom was at market with my dad. And I would go down in the basement and wipe my tears as I was going down the basement because I had to do this by myself. Mom wasn't home. And it really gave me a wonderful, at the time it didn't seem wonderful, but looking back, it was really the foundation for my love of baking. And the lesson that I learned there was perseverance. Do what you don't feel like doing and you'll be successful. So I did a lot of that. But anyway, I just began to enjoy baking. And so it's always been within me, you know, just the love of that.
Yeah.
And so when Gentry said, make the cookbook, I was like, wow. So the hard part was we had to get all the recipes fine-tuned.
Get them right so that people could follow them.
That's right.
And yeah, because that's got to be the hard part.
It was very difficult. And so we had we did over 100 recipes, I believe, and I had to bake or make whatever it was, all of them about three times, and then you know, write it all down. So it was just a labor of love, but it was truly laborious.
Oh, I'm sure. So what is it that you love about baking? What is it that you love about cooking?
Wow. I think that was, you know, as a kid, I remember baking cookies and pies, and there was mom and dad or the rest of the siblings would comment on, this is good. I don't know. It sounds silly, but I loved making something really good and getting a great response.
Yeah.
It gave me just a lot of satisfaction. I was serving in that way.
Sure.
But I also got an instant reward. Like,
right.
Ooh. So I knew I could
knew
do
it
this
tasted
well.
Good. Yeah.
And my dad, he would always brag on the baked goods at market and say, my daughter made these pies and cakes. And I don't know. There was something very satisfying because I knew I was pleasing my parents, number one.
And, yeah. And then the people who ate it.
The taste buds. Everybody liked yeah. what I baked. So it was good.
I love
that.
Come to the Table is the name of Annie Ann's new cookbook. It's available anywhere. They can go to your website, annieannbeiler.com. Mm-hmm. They can check it out. Your other books are available there too, I'm
yes.
assuming.
Yes, they are.
And you're going to have a book signing coming up this weekend. Tell
yes.
us about that.
Yeah, we're going to be at the Nooks in Lancaster on Sunday. And I believe that it's a ticketed event. And we're just really excited to... come home, you know.
Yeah.
I'm coming home to my roots.
And yeah, because you guys moved to Texas a few years back.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Yes. And so we're going to do this book signing at 4:30 on Sunday at the Nooks in Lancaster City.
Yeah.
And I love coming home. You know,
yeah.
this Lancaster County is truly where I was born and raised and lived here most of my life.
Yeah.
And I do still feel like I'm coming home, and
you
I love
are.
That feeling.
Yeah, I love that, too. The book signing's at Nooks, North Prince Street in Lancaster, 4:30 to 6. You could sign up at Annie Ann's website, annieannbeiler.com, and there's /register there. You can check that out. All the info is there. You have social media, I'm assuming.
Correct.
Facebook and Instagram and everything. People
yes,
can
we do.
Follow
yes.
you as well. Our very special guest today, Annie Ann Beiler, is here. We're talking about her cookbook, among many other things. Good morning, Annie Ann.
Good morning, Fred. Great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Oh, we love having you here. Now, some people are surprised that Annie Ann is a real person.
That's right.
They might also be surprised to find out that you grew up Amish,
mm-hmm.
and then you guys changed, kind of converted to Amish-Mennonite,
yes.
which some people who aren't from the area wouldn't understand. That was a big deal in
yeah.
your day,
yeah.
right?
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
So confusing to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
But I understand mom and dad were old order Amish with, meaning horse and buggy Amish. And
right.
my dad wanted to farm with tractors. He did not like horses. And that was really his inspiration to leave the old order Amish and then go to the Amish Mennonite community, which is very similar to Amish, except that we had cars. And we could have electricity. So at the age of, I was about 3 when they left. So
okay, interesting.
My old order Amish days, I don't remember much, but my grandparents and all of my aunts and uncles. And so it was a very, the culture was very strong in our family. And
yeah.
I loved, my childhood was very secure. And I really enjoyed the, just a family, faith, family, community was what we grew up in. And, you know, last night we had we spent the evening on the farm that I grew up, that where I was born and lived there until I was about 10 or 12, on Butter Road here in close to Lancaster. And we
yeah.
spent the night, the evening, with the family there at our old home place. And the Amish people still live there. And there was about 100 of us there last night.
For a reunion?
Just to
a
get together.
Reunion.
And they cooked
yeah.
us a meal. And a lot of their family was there.
How
and
amazing.
My family was there. So it was really, I love coming home.
Yeah. yeah. Not only have you created and invented Annie Ann's pretzels, which are the best pretzels anywhere, but
you
love baking and you made a cookbook.
Correct.
And it's wonderful. My curiosity, I mean, Gentry was just telling us about the 2-year plan of making this book and then taking all the pictures in one day, which just sounds crazy to me. But do you have any favorites from this cookbook?
There's a couple of favorites. Of course, most of the recipes are from my mom, but I've had a number of them also from friends or family
okay.
that I've used during the years. And my favorite, I want to say the dessert, a cookie recipe would be the soft sugar cookie. And I have made thousands of those cookies.
yeah.
And people, before Auntie Anne's, many people know me because I made those sugar cookies and brought them to birthday parties, or I don't know.
Yeah.
I didn't even realize that most people knew about the sugar cookie. It's a soft, the flavor is nutmeg, and it is it's my favorite cookie. And then I have maybe a favorite dessert would be Rhoda's apple roll, which again, it was my sister-in-law. And it's a very easy dessert. If you love apples, we make it with croissant rolls.
Mm.
And It's just easy, but it's the best apple dessert that you will ever have, thanks to Rhoda.
Yeah.
And then I guess when it comes to like a meal, like for a meat, I love the roast beef. It's probably by now at my age, if you come to my house, I'm going to make you a roast beef because I've made so many of them and it's a great dish.
Well, it's quite the hefty book. I mean, this is a great size book. It has so many. How many recipes does it have?
A hundred or so.
Wow. That's amazing. Come to the table. Annie Anne Beiler has a brand new cookbook out. It's just one of her five books that are available at her website, annieannebeiler.com. What is the thing like in making this book, when you look at it, what is the thing that you go, I am so happy we did this because?
Well, because come to the table is there's a meaning behind that. You know, growing up in our culture, we had sat around the table. Mom would always, in Dutch, it's Zeit für Essen. It's time to eat 3 times a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And there was no exception to the rule. And again, there were 8 of us kids and mom and dad, 10 of us sitting around the table. If dad was out in the farm plowing the field, or if someone was out in the garden, come to the table. And when I say that to you right now, I can feel the
pull.
The pull there. Yeah. Come to the table. And I think the inspiration behind the book for me was to encourage people to come to the table with your family.
Yeah.
It's there that we learn how to communicate. We talked about the things that happened during the day. And my dad would often talk about what he read in the newspaper. We didn't have a radio or TV, of course not.
Right.
And but it was where we connected. We learned how to share. There was clearly we had to share ice cream. Mom would buy one box of ice cream. She would cut it in 10 pieces, and that's we all got some ice cream.
That's awesome.
So there was so many valuable lessons around the table, and more than the recipes in my cookbook, the inspiration for me was come to the table.
Yeah.
As families, you know, it's hard to do that, and but if you can just like start a new tradition in your home, one night a week, let's get together, turn TV off, let's let our cell phones somewhere else,
and right,
come to the table as a family and talk, learn how to communicate. It's a beautiful gift that God gave to me because my mom and dad said come to the table every single day of my life.
Yeah, I love that. That's beautiful. You can come to the table with Annie Anne and her brand new cookbook. Not only that, you can meet her and get to say hello to her. She's home here for just a short time. You're going to be at Nook's Bookstore in Lancaster.
Yes.
It's on Prince Street. It's this Sunday, 4:30 to 6. People do have to register to come,
that's right?
That's
right. But please, come one, come all. Let's. I want to just say hello to y'all and give you a big hug. And I really want to meet some folks from Lancaster County.
Yeah, come out to Nook's. It's on 112 North Prince Street, Lancaster, 4:30 to 6 this Sunday. Sign up, annieannebeiler.com/register. Also, Annie Anne is available on social media anywhere, Facebook, Instagram, all that kind of stuff as well.
Yes, can check that's out. Correct.
And it was so wonderful to have you back here again. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, Fred, for having
me.
Yeah,
Lord bless you. And it's just the smile on your face has made our day. So thanks for coming out.